Hi everyone, my name is C.H. Venugopal Reddy, Assistant Professor in Civil Department. I am dealing with StatPro Lab. So first experiment is Introduction to StatPro.
So this is the manual, Advanced Structural Design Laboratory, Lab Manual. That is StatPro Manual. So you can, this is available in the IRE website. You can see, you can study this. And what are the different experiments in this? What are the different experiments we have? First one is Introduction to StatPro, Analysis of Continuous Beam, Analysis of Single Story Film. Like this, different experiments are there. So first experiment is, experiment number is Introduction on StatPro. What is StatPro is, what is the full form of StatPro is, Structural Analysis and Design. Structural Analysis and Design. It is a computer program. It is a computer program developed by Bentley. Company name is Bentley. Initially, it was developed by research engineers. It was taken by Bentley Systems. So they have developed this StatPro. Previously, it was StatPro was Stat 3, and after that it was changed to Stat V8i version. These are the latest version. So what is the StatPro can be used for any, can be used for several materials like steel, concrete and timber design codes. All codes will be available, all country codes will be available in the StatPro. All country codes will be available in StatPro. We can do any type of analysis in this. We can do any type of analysis in this easily without any difficulty. So what is the advantages of StatPro is, what easy to use interface, easy to use, very easily we can use the interface. Confirmation with Indian standard codes. Confirmation with the Indian standard codes are available in StatPro. All whatever available Indian standard codes for design and analysis that are available in the, not only Indian standard codes, other country codes are also there. Versatile nature of solving any type of problem. Any type of problem can be solved easily with the StatPro. And fourth one is accuracy of the results. Accuracy of the solution. So what, if you give the correct values, you will get the correct solution. If you give wrong values, you will get wrong values. The computer will give wrong values. So in this, so many methods are there. Different methods are there. Methods of StatPro. Snap and grid method. Structural wizard method. Excel method, snap and grid method. So snap and grid, here we can see here. You open the window, no, open the stand, your file name will be there. File name will be there. Location of the file, you have to give the file name. And location, where you have to locate that file, where you have to save that file. Units are English units and metric units. English units and metric units. So snap and grid method means this one, x values and y values you have to give. That is snap and grid method. Snap and grid method, you have to give the x values, x and y z. From that we can create the structure. And next one is structural wizard. See, structural wizard, structural wizard, directly frames will be available, frame models. Directly we can select number of base or number of bay frame, grid frame, everything. From that, from this also we can create the structure. And for trusses also we can create the, for trusses also we can create from the these frames. That is, we call it as structural wizard method. And one more is excel method. Here you can see different commands are there: geometry, view, select, specification, loading, everything is there. So structure, you have already seen snap and grid method, structural wizard, excel method, dxf method means you have to draw in the drawing in the AutoCAD, that is converted into the dxf method. So automatically you can create the structure. If you import that drawing into the STAT, we can create the structure. One more is STAT editor method. In the editor method also you can write the program. STAT editor method. You can write the program. If you see in the utilities, command file is there, no? So here you can directly write the program. To write the program here in the STAT editor, STAT connected editor, the structure will be created. But nowadays we are not using this directly, we are building, previously, some 10 years back we are using this editor, STAT editor. But for some commands you want to change, you can change in the editor. So like this, this is the introduction. So different methods are there, you have seen. And why we have questions, what is the use of AutoCAD in STAT? I just know to know DXF, your AutoCAD drawing is converted into, AutoCAD drawing is converted into DXF file, and that is imported to the STAT. What is the difference between global and local access? Local access means at a particular point, in a structure, if you take there the different axis, we call it as local axis. And global axis means complete structure we have to consider for global axis. What are the different types of loads that acts on this structure? Different types of loads are, one you already studied in the RCC, that so many loads are there. One is dead load. Dead load is taken from IS 875 part 1, and live load is there. Live load is taken from IS-875 part 2. And wind loads are there. Wind loads is from IS-875 part 3. And similarly, snow loads also there. IS-875 part 4, part 5 are snow loads, temperature loads are will be there. And earthquake loads will be taken from IS-1893. The code for earthquake loads is IS-1893. So these are the different loads acting on the structure. Loads. What are different types of supports? You already know, you have studied at fixed support, in support, roller support, and some other supports also there. What is the code book for RCC design? RCC design, you already know. You already studied the RCC, you know, IS-456. Define StatPro, I just know, you know. What is the difference between AutoCAD and StatPro? That also you know. So how to select nodes in StatPro? How to select nodes in StatPro and how to select beams in StatPro.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.